everyone, welcome back to TechnonTechTV. In this tutorial, we will learn about PLSQL data types. So let's start. PLSQL data types are not just limited to writing SQL queries, but they are used in the PLSQL block as well, just like any other programming language. So providing a data type specifies how any data will be stored and processed by Oracle when any PLSQL code block is executed. So data type defines the type of data being used, whether it is a number or a word, string or a single character, etc. So these data types can be used in PLSQL depending upon the type of data required. So we have four broader categories of data types, and they are scalar type, lob types, reference types and composite types. So first we have scalar types. These are basic data types which generally holds a single value like a number or a string of characters. So scalar type have four different categories which are listed in the diagram, namely number types, character and string, boolean types and date and time, etc. Next we have lob types. This data types deal with the large objects and is used to specify location of these large objects like text file, images, etc., which are generally not stored outside the database. And reference types is used to hold pointer values, which generally stores address of other program items. And last but not the least is composite types. As the name suggests, this type of data is a composition of individual data which can be manipulated or processed separately as well. So in this tutorial we won't be covering all these different data types, but we will be covering the ones which are most widely used. So first we have number data type. This data type is used to store numeric data. Here P is precision and S is scale. So range for P is 1 to 38 and for S it is minus 84 to 127. So let's take an example. Here age is a variable that can store two digits. So suppose this is a column age and I'm storing value 14 and 16. So if I store three digit number like 516, then this value is not accepted. Let's take another example. Here percentage is a variable. So in percentage column, we can store value like this. So when it says a number in bracket 4,2, it means that there will be four digits and that the number should be rounded to the nearest hundredth, and which means that there will be two digits before and two digits after the decimal point. Next is CHAR data type. Its range is starting from 1 to 2000 bytes. This data type is used to store alphabetical string of fixed length. Its value is quoted in single quotes, and each value stored in a CHAR type column will be having fixed storage size of 4 bytes. So if the string length is lower than the 4 bytes, extra spaces are padded at the end of the string, that is write padding. Unlike CHAR data type, the storage size of the data stored in VARCHAR is not fixed. If the string length is lower than 4 bytes, it does not add any extra spaces and the size of the data is exactly the same as the string length. In simple word, CHAR is to store the fixed length string and VARCHAR is to store the variable length string. So let's make it simple to understand with an example. Consider this table. Here CHAR takes consistent storage of 4 bytes and VARCHAR takes variable length storage based on the data to be stored. So even if we store the empty string, CHAR takes 4 bytes of storage, whereas VARCHAR needs only 1 byte storage to save an empty string. And see the fourth row. So if the length of the string is greater than the allotted storage space for both CHAR and VARCHAR, the string gets trimmed to a maximum length of storage space. The string ABCDEFGH has length 8 bytes, but the data size to store is 4 bytes. So ABCDEFGH is trimmed to ABCD and saved in the table. Next we have VARCHAR2. So it is same as VARCHAR. This data type is also used to store alphanumeric string of variable length. Its value is also quoted in single quotes. So how VARCHAR2 is different from VARCHAR? So MySQL support only two string data types, char and VARCHAR, whereas Oracle support additional VARCHAR2 variable length string data type. So if you are using MySQL, you do not need to worry about VARCHAR2. In Oracle, VARCHAR is reserved to redefine in the future to distinguish empty and null string. On another end, in VARCHAR2, null and an empty string are considered as the same. Apart from this, both string data types behave the same. As VARCHAR is preserved for the future and can be redefined, it is not advisable to use VARCHAR. If your projects rely on an empty string and null string being the same, VARCHAR2 is most suitable. Next, we have date data type. Its range is starting from 1 January 4712 BC to 31st December 9999. It stores the data in date format like this. The value for this data type is written in single quotes. So let's take an example. Here, DOB is a variable that stores date of birth in defined format, that is 21st Feb 1991. Next, we have person type. It store value of that variable whose data type is unknown, and when we want the variable to inherit the data type of the table column. Also, its value is generally being retrieved from an existing table in the database. Hence, it takes the data type of column for which it is used. So consider this example. Here, student is the name of the table created in database, and roll number is a variable whose data type is unknown, and person type is used to store its value. Last, we have Boolean data type. This data type is used in conditional statements. It stores logic values. It can be either true or false. Consider this example. Here, isAdmin is a variable whose value can be true or false, depending upon the condition being checked. So the data types covered in this tutorial are the ones which are most commonly used, but there are many more different data types for which you can check the official Oracle website. I have added the link in the description box. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. Do share this video with your friends to spread the knowledge. And if you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos.